Honorable Speaker, thank you for the opportunity. I commend my honorable colleague, Honorable Samuel Kwizeto Ablakwa of North Tongu for the well-researched and eloquently presented statement. Mr. Speaker, Atimota has been a beacon of hope for many young men and women. Atimota has been defined by its history of inclusion. Atimota is a school that travels around the length and breadth of Ghana recruiting students. And they have a story to tell of how Atimota changed them and made them leaders who have led this country and led their families, led their communities, and have done a fantastic job in various professions. Atimota is defined by a history of inclusion and a history that has given hope to many, as I have said. Mr. Speaker, the Ghana Education Service provides opportunity for all students to blossom and to have quality education. Mr. Speaker, I understand the argument that is raging in this country. I can understand where everyone is coming from in terms of the convictions that they have for or against the debate that we are talking about. But Mr. Speaker, I can assure you that Ghana Education Service, within the shortest possible time, is going to lay out specific guidelines for head of schools as to how we proceed in this environment. Mr. Speaker, I can tell you that meetings have been had, others are ongoing, the ministry facilitating to make sure that our students operate in an environment where they give up their best, not just to themselves, but to this nation. Mr. Speaker, the President of the Republic, Nana Addo Akufo-Addo, has made great, directed great investment be made by this country in education. Look at the number of students who have benefited from free senior high school, but that is an access issue. He's not looking at quality. We're talking about science, technology, engineering, and mathematics, STEM centers being built across the country, the curriculum being changed to reflect computing, and other important aspects of work in school. That is what this government is about, and this government is about ensuring that education becomes that vehicle for socioeconomic transformation, and that Ghana competes just like any country in this world. That is what has preoccupied us at the Ministry of Education, that we can bring the President's vision into reality, that we'll be able to increase the gross tertiary enrollment by 2030 to 40%. That is our major preoccupation. Any other thing that comes up, we'll make sure that the distraction is removed and that students can learn and that teachers can teach and that parents will have the peace of mind to also guide their students. So, Mr. Speaker, I can assure you that the ministry is not sleeping at the wheel. The ministry is on top of this, and we'll come to a conclusion that Ghanaians will respect. But I appeal to all that let us, irrespective of our emotions about this, let us calm down and understand Atimota, that great institution, has been an institution of inclusion and has never been an institution of exclusion. And Atimota will live up to its great expectation of educating the leaders of Ghana. It will continue to do so, Mr. Speaker. So I want every Ghanaian to understand that at the end of the day, the vision of Atimota will forever live on. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.